Do you want to learn how to trade stocks and cryptocurrency? Join our community of traders. Go to richpicksdaily.com and find the next 10 bagger. Hi, how's everybody doing today? I'm your host, Rich, here on behalf of Rich TV Live with our very special guest, Brian Slesarchuk, the CEO of Fosterville South Exploration. How are you doing today, Brian?
Doing really well, Rich. Thank you.
Hey, thank you for joining us again. Very excited to speak with you today about Fosterville South Exploration. We've already started talking about the company a little bit, and our investors and our community is excited to learn more. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got involved with Fosterville South Exploration.
Absolutely, Rich. Fosterville South Exploration just came to trade a year ago on the TSX Venture, but the company was a multi-year process in terms of putting the land package together. And I think that's really important to note. Rex Motten, who's the COO and a co-founder of Fosterville South, is very much a local Victoria, Australian geologist. He lives just minutes away from our tenements. He lives just minutes away from Kirkland Lake Gold's Fosterville mine tenements. And while Rex had a very successful career internationally as a geologist, he always kept an eye on his own backyard. And when Kirkland Lake started to have some of the early success at their Fosterville mine, Rex quickly assembled the premier exploration land package in Victoria, and he had a multi-year head start on the current modern-day gold rush that is going on right now.
Can you tell us a little bit about what your main goals are for 2021 for Fosterville South Exploration?
Absolutely, and the goals are all drill-centric or drill-focused. Over the past year, there was a lot of preparation work done. We came to trade as a public company. We went out and we raised capital in conjunction with that move to the TSX Venture. And on the ground, we did a whole lot of work in terms of permitting, getting drill contractors lined up and signed, doing geochemistry and soils on the various projects, going through historic drill records, production records, et cetera. And where that has led us to today is a program that's very focused on the drill bit for the next 12 to 18 months. In fact, right now, as we speak, Rich, we're drilling three different projects concurrently in Victoria. So this will be a year that will be driven by drill results. And that's really predicated on the past year, which has been very much about generating drill targets, getting the crews in place, getting the technical team in place, getting permits in place, and really going through all of the past data. And there's extensive past data on these projects to be ready for drilling.
Yeah, now speaking on that, Fosterville South Exploration recently announced it started drilling at the Golden Mountain Project. Can you go through this news with us and let us know what this means for the company?
Absolutely. So Golden Mountain was the first project we had ready for drilling. So we were drilling that as our first project out of the gate, and we had some sensational gold intercepts in that first round of drilling. We then stopped at Golden Mountain, assessed the data. It was a predetermined fire season stop there. There's some brush, et cetera, at Golden Mountain. So there's a normal seasonal shutdown. That shutdown that occurs every year is over. And we're now drilling again at Golden Mountain, following up on some of those excellent gold intercepts that we've had over the past 12 months. At the same time, we've started to drill at our Lauriston project, and also our Moorabool project. So drills are turning on three different projects there. And incidentally, Lauriston and Moorabool are projects that we can drill year round. So I don't anticipate drilling to stop anytime soon We're extremely well funded with close to $30 million in cash on hand. And in addition to drilling at Golden Mountain, drilling at Lauriston, drilling at Morimble, we're also bringing a fourth project online in relatively short order. So there will be a lot of news flow in the weeks and months ahead.
Now, you spoke on this. Fosterville South Exploration recently secured access agreement to drill high-grade target at Keats Reward Lauriston Project. What is the potential at this property, and what could it mean for Fosterville if the targets are achieved?
Sure. So at Golden Mountain, we had some sensational early results. Like I said, we're following those up. But in reality, a lot of the excitement about Fosterville South exploration has been generated because of the Lauriston project. And there are a few reasons for that. Number one, Lauriston is immediately south and actually borders the Kirkland Lake Gold Fosterville mine tenements. In addition to being contiguous with Kirkland Lake Gold's Fosterville mine tenements, it's a big property. It's 600 square kilometers, again, on the southern border of those mine tenements. We also have the big regional structures running through the Lauriston project that also run through the Kirkland Lake Fosterville mine tenements. We see gold with antimony there in spades. You've got the big structures, the geological characteristics, and the proximity to a mine that has been for several years the world's highest grade and the world's lowest cost gold miner.
Wow. Now, you mentioned it a little bit with Kirkland Lake. Is there any other big mining companies in the same region as you guys? And if so, what sets you apart from your competitors?
Well, it was really interesting, Rich. This region historically was a prolific gold mining region, but a lot of that mining was done in the late 1800s up until about 1910. And then there were stops and starts. And some of the grades were exceptional. For example, at Lauriston, there was significant hard rock, high-grade gold production reported historically in the late 1800s. But despite that, and despite the geological characteristics being similar to the Fosterville mine, despite the big regional structures running through both projects, it has seen very limited modern systematic exploration and very little exploration at depth. And again, once Kirkland Lake started to have that success, Rex as a first mover and due to his backyard hometown advantage was able to put together the premier exploration land package in Victoria. And of course, that gives us a big leg up, I think, on some of the later entrants to the region. Now, that being said, it's great to see the gold rush occur there, such as it has over the last 12 months. And with that in mind, you're going to see an incredible amount of drilling in the area over the next year. Kirkland Lake Gold has a huge program. We have a very big program. Remember, in total, our land package, including granted exploration licenses and applications, that land package totals approximately 4,000 square kilometers. So we have a huge series of parcels of projects that have great potential for high-grade gold. What's also happening in Victoria right now is that the government is conducting a process through which some more companies will enter the fray by an auction-type process or a bid-type process. And we understand there are likely some major mining companies participating in that. So in addition to the activity of Kirkland Lake, of Fosterville South, you'll have several juniors and possibly some majors drilling over the next 12 months. So it's just going to be a very, very busy part of the world. In fact, many people consider this the world's most important region for high-grade gold exploration.
Wow, that's a great place to be. Can you go through some of the team at Fosterville South Exploration and what each key member brings to the table?
Sure. Rex Mottin is really a key piece of this team. He not only assembled this land package, but he's operating as Fosterville South's chief operating officer. Rex is a co-founder and was able to assemble this land package over a multi-year process. Rex is really the guy leading the charge in Victoria. And one thing that is interesting to note is that while Rex was working around the world internationally, and as I mentioned before, keeping an eye on his own backyard, he also compiled and maintained a database for decades of all of the past production work in this region, the past exploration work in this region, et cetera. And that, of course, was just invaluable as Fosterville South had its first mover status in terms of land assembly. We also have a great technical advisor by the name of Doug Kerwin. Doug is a Taylor Lindsley Award winner, extremely well-recognized geologist around the world. Doug is also from Australia and has been an integral part of the advisory process as we unleash our exploration program. We've got, as an independent director, John Lewins. John is well known to most mining investors. He is the current CEO of K92 Mining. K92 Mining is a company that I co-founded and I'm former president and a former director of. And I've watched John execute as the CEO at K92 and just being exceptionally impressed. John is a true professional, a visionary in the business, one of the best technical operators, I think, in the industry. And we're really fortunate to have John as a director. So we've got a great team of people in Victoria. We've got a great team of people on the capital market side, on the advisory side of things. A lady by the name of Lisa Gazis is on our board. She is based in Victoria. She has had a very remarkable career in this region, including working at the Kirkland Lake Fosterville operation. So it's a really well-rounded team with a blend of skill sets. And I think that's always important when you put together these companies. You've got to have great people with geology background, engineering background, logistics background, and also capital markets experience. And I think we do have a good blend of talents on this team at Fosterville South.
Yeah, sounds like it. Sounds like you have a great team. And one of the things that we like to identify is a tight share structure. And one of the things I liked when I went through the company was you guys have a very responsible share structure. Can you break down the share structure and how the company plans to introduce more institutional and retail investors to the company?
Absolutely, Rich. Despite the fact of having close to $30 million in treasury, we have less than 68 million shares issued. So we've maintained a tight share structure, even though, again, we have close to $30 million in cash. The last fundraise we did was a $7.5 million raise at $4. The financing prior to that was a $15 million fundraise at $1.10. And we were really fortunate early on to attract not only some of Canada's best mining institutional funds, but also some great mining entrepreneurs who believed in the project. In our first news release out of the gate, we were able to announce that large shareholders included Eric Sprott and also included Ross Beattie. So we've attracted some people that have had some enormous success in the space. And of course, Eric has notably had some incredible success in this particular region. As you will know, and your viewers will know, he was the chairman of Kirkland Lake Gold when they were having the remarkable early success at the Fosterville mine. So really proud to have not only some of Canada's top mining institutions as investors on the roster, but also mining professionals like Eric Sprott and Ross Beattie.
Those are some powerhouses for sure in the mining space. And what better than Eric Sprott, who, like you said, has been in that region with Kirkland Lake and had so much success. So that is a great sign. And that's a man who knows exactly what he's doing. And same with Ross Beatty. If there was one thing you would want shareholders to know today about Fosterville South Exploration, what would it be?
What I would say, Rich, is that while the company just came to trade during the last year, it was a multi-year process to put together this 4,000 square kilometer package. And the credit on that goes to Rex. We're extremely well-funded to now escalate our exploration program. And with multiple drills turning, again, we're drilling now at Golden Mountain. We're drilling at Lauriston. We're drilling at Moranbah. We'll be drilling at other projects in short order. With all of this drilling activity, this year will be extremely busy with a lot of news flow about the fundamental progress on the ground. So that's what I'd like to impart on shareholders, was that the past 12 months have been about preparation, funding, building the team, building the targets, and now it's all about drilling.
That's great. And we're going to have shareholders watching this video from all over the world. What's the best way for them to get in contact with the company?
Sure. Through our website at Fosterville South Exploration, you'll find the phone number, contact information there. Our filings are on SEDAR. We trade as FSX on the TSX Venture and FSXLF in the United States.
Well, thank you for joining us again, Brian Slezarchuk, the CEO of Fosterville South Exploration.
Great. Thanks a lot for having me, Rich.
Always a pleasure. Now, before we say goodbye, just remember that Rich TV Live is strictly for information and education purposes. Please consult a financial advisor before you ever invest in any of the companies that we feature here on Rich TV Live. If you like the video, please smash the like button, comment down below, share the video everywhere, and subscribe. Now, in my own opinion, after doing all my due diligence and interviewing Brian, I believe this is a company that has a great future. I believe it's undervalued, underappreciated, underexposed, with money in the bank. And do you guys have any debt?
No, there's no debt. And like I say, approximately $30 million in cash.
$30 million in cash, no debt, and 68 million shares fully diluted. I think you guys are a gold mine, literally a gold mine. And I'd love to know what the audience's opinion is. Please, guys, comment on the video. Let me know what you think about Fosterville South Exploration. Brian, thank you for joining us again. And for everyone who's watching, have a nice day, everybody. Oh,